So we were discussing what should be done before postural drainage, during postural drainage, and after postural drainage. So last few lectures we discussed before and during. So today we will discuss after postural drainage. What is your role? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
These things we discussed. Checking phases of cuff. One second. So after postural drainage, active or passive removal of the secretion from the main bronchus. That is, the postural drainage will remove the secretion from periphery to or from smaller airway to larger airway. Clear? Postural drainage will drain the secretion from smaller airway. That is, you know what is smaller airway or peripheral airway? Here, you know, there are made so many branches, divisions are there, generations are there, and finally, this is smaller airway. This areas are smaller airways or peripheral airways. So, what does the postural drainage does? That is, what you will achieve after giving postural drainage? Yes, the secretion will reach the central airway. This is called central airway, main bronchus, or this is called main bronchus and trachea and main bronchus. Clear? So the secretions will ultimately, it will reach this particular area, or maybe this particular area. Clear? So clear, the secretion, don't think that when you do postural drainage it will directly come out. If you in postural drainage position, any postural drainage position, maximum you can drain or maximum the secretion can reach this level. Clear? So that is not your purpose. The purpose is you have to remove the secretion out. Clear? So after postural drainage, what is the main thing you have to do is either, that is, you have to remove the secretions from main bronchus. Clear? After postural drainage, now the secretions are lying here, either here or here. Secretions will be either, it will reach this particular area or here. Clear? So your aim is to remove this secretion outside. That is the main purpose of postural drainage. So it can be removed either actively or passively. That is, removal of the secretion from the main bronchus either through active mode or passive mode. What is active removal? Active removal is cuff or huff. It is called as active removal of the secretions. So if the patient is not cuffing or if the patient is not huffing after postural drainage, it is of waste. In order to remove, patient should actively participate by cuffing or huffing. If suppose a patient is in unconscious, state, or if the patient, what is other example? If the patient is immediately post after post-operative period, post-operative, so there may be stitches. There may be stitches. So because of pain, and when the patient is coughing, the patient may have pain due to stitches. Clear? So he cannot able to cough actively. So, or if the patient is unconscious, or if the patient is in coma state. So what you will do? You will remove passively. You will remove the secretion passively. So how passively you will remove, that we will discuss later. So either actively or passively, you will remove the secretion from the main bronchus. We are studying after postural drainage. Okay, already we discussed active coughing or huffing passively by a suction apparatus. There is an equipment called suction apparatus. You will clear the secretion by using this apparatus. And phases of cough, I think we have already discussed this. Active, voluntary cough, involuntary cough, we have already discussed in detail. It has four phases: irritation, inspiration, compression, and expulsion. No? Voluntary cough and involuntary cough. Two types of coughs are there. Voluntary cough is, what is voluntary cough? Voluntary cough has how many phases? Anyone? Voluntary cough, how many phases? It has three phases. Voluntary cough has three phases. Involuntary cough has four phases. What is voluntary? You are performing voluntarily. Clear? Voluntary cough. There, this phase is absent. Irritation phase will not be there. Voluntary cough consists of inspiration, compression, and expulsion. Voluntary phase or voluntary cough. And what is other cough? Involuntary cough. Involuntary means patient cannot able to cough by himself. In that stage, in that situation, a patient needs irritation. I will explain this. Irritation. After irritation, the inspiration will start. So it has four phases. So what phase? Involuntary cough has four phase and voluntary cough has three phase. So what I had, this is what here shown is, it is an involuntary cough because irritation is included. So what is this irritation? Okay, there are many types of irritation. Is nothing but it's stimulation. Irritation, you can otherwise call it as stimulation, or proper word is external stimulation. External stimulation is given in order to get the cough. So this external stimulation is called as an irritation phase. Other name is irritation phase. So how the cough can be improved? By teaching proper positioning. Forced expiration. And you can try on yourself. When you try to expire forcefully, stimulation will be, there will be a cough, cough will be stimulated. When you are trying to exhale forcefully, the cough will be stimulated. Clear? This is one. Second is pressure over extra thoracic trachea. Clear? You place your finger on the suprasternal notch. You know where is suprasternal notch? Yes, this is suprasternal notch. Clear? Sternum, above sternum there is a notch. Clear? This is called suprasternal notch. Can you see me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So place your finger, index finger, on the suprasternal notch. and you slightly push your finger inside. So what happened? Cuff is stimulated. So this phase is called as irritation phase. Clear? So normally if the patient is coughing by himself, that is called voluntary cuff. This is voluntary cuff, which has only three phases. Irritation, clear, sorry, inspiration, compression, expulsion. That is voluntary cuff. The patient who cannot cough by themselves, they need additional phase called irritation phase. Irritation is nothing but an external stimulation. So place your index finger and press inside, then they will cough it. Clear? So this is the technique to what cough? Involuntary cough. Clear? So these are the techniques to improve the cuff. So pressure is applied over the extra thoracic area or suprasternal notch to elicit the cuff. And third point, I think fourth point. First, proper positioning will improve the cuff. Second is forced expiration will improve the cuff. Pressure over the external thoracic trachea will also improve the cuff. And NMF, neuromuscular facilitation, that is intermittent application of ice over the paraspinal muscles, especially in thoracic spine. That is the thoracic spine, paraspinal area, that is on either side of the spine. Paraspinal muscles, you would have studied in thoracic area. If you stimulate that area with the ice for 3 to 5 seconds, it will also stimulate the cuff due to the reflex. Clear? And reflex cuff are stronger than voluntary cuff. Clear? Reflex cuff or, oh, these are some points, additional points to improve the cuff. Now, well, I think these things slides we have already discussed. Okay. Now, suctioning. We are studying things to remember after postural drainage. First, we discussed cuff. This is first point, cuff. After, we are discussing after postural drainage. Clear? First is cuffing technique. And second is, these are the things you should keep in mind after postural drainage. Suctioning also we discussed. So suctioning is better, or it is advisable, before and after PD. Clear? If patient can't cuff. If patient can cuff or huff actively, he can do it. Suction is should be given only if patient is not able to cuff, or if he cannot able to cuff. Next is ACBT. This also we discussed. If you remember these slides, equal pressure point we discussed. Cuffing with mid lung volume, low lung volume, high lung volume. So these things also should be kept in mind after postural drainage. Clear? So what is first? First is cuffing technique. Cuff technique. Second is suctioning. And third is active cycle of breathing. And fourth is, there are some mechanical percussors available. Clear? These are some theory regarding mechanical percussor. So if you apply these mechanical devices,
over the chest wall in postural drainage position. In postural drainage position, if you apply these devices, it will create shock wave, or it trans shock waves are transmitted through the chest wall and it loosens the secretion. This should be applicable, or this is applied only when the secretions are tenacious or thick. If the secretions are thick and if it is adherent, if it is sticking to the wall, then you will use this type of mechanical devices. Often dependent on positioning to drain mucus into the upper airway. Okay. Patient is positioned for optimal drainage of the lobe to be percussed, with each area to be treated 2 to 5 minutes. You know, for every segment the position is different. So in each and every position, the segments which you wish to drain, you have to position first, then you have to apply these devices. There is one more device called positive expiratory pressure. This is called PEP devices. PEP. PEP device. What is PEP device? Anyone have an idea? What is positive expiratory pressure, negative expiratory pressure, zero expiratory pressure? Are you aware of these terminologies?
Yes, sir.
What is it? What is PE, EP, NE, EP, ZE, EP? Kya hota hai?
Sir, in PEP device, we can give it device to patient in from so that patient can like exhale the cough in that device.
Oh, what is PEEP? PEEP. What does it mean? Bhakti?
Sir, positive and expiratory pressure.
Bhakti, where are you?
Yes, sir.
What is NEEP?
Negative expiratory pressure.
आपका सिग्नल वीक है क्या? बीच में आपने कुछ बोला नहीं है.
यस सर.
बीच में तो आप अगेन रिपीट इट. व्हाट इज
कैन आई टाइप
अगेन रिपीट व्हाट इज NEEP?
NEEP नेगेटिव एक्सपिरेटरी प्रेशर.
निकाल चलेंगे फिर. नेगेटिव
एक्सपिरेटरी प्रेशर.
अरे डबल ही आता है यहाँ पे, दो ही है यहाँ पे.
सर कैन आई टाइप इट?
हाँ हाँ टाइप इट. यस Yes, very good. Negative and expiratory pressure. And what is ZEEP?
Zero and expiratory pressure.
Zero and expiratory pressure. What does it mean? Anyone can explain? This is expiration and this is inspiration. Clear? This is positive side, this is negative side. Clear? So what happens during inspiration?
the pressure within the lung is negative. Clear? This is the graph related to the what? It is related, something related to the pressure. Clear? You know 760 millimeter of mercury is the atmospheric pressure, or you can call it as, in respiratory system, it is considered as zero. Clear? MMHG. MMHG, 760 MMHG in respiratory system, it is considered as zero. Clear? You can write zero also. And what is this is minus one. What is minus one? What is minus one?
Negative pressure.
अरे नेगेटिव प्रेशर तो है 760 माइनस 1 क्या है क्या हो गया यार 759 इन रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम इट इज कॉल्ड माइनस 1 क्लियर और 761 In respiratory system, it is called plus one. Clear? So, I am writing only zero, minus one, plus one. And you understand, minus one is 759, zero is 760, plus one is 761. So, this is the pressure within the lung. Intraalveolar pressure is minus one. What happens during, now I will draw another graph which shows amount of air entered into the lung. Now this is 500 ml of air it enters during inspiration. Clear? During inspiration, 500 ml of air, it enters into the lung. Clear? So when you are taking inspiration, listen carefully. What is PEEP? What is P? This is, okay, I'll take another color. So this is beginning of inspiration, and this is end of inspiration. This point is beginning of inspiration. This is end of expiration. Normally, end of inspiration. Clear? This point is beginning of inspiration. This point is end of inspiration. Clear? So now, what is NEEP means? At the end, okay, first I'll explain zero. What is zero end expiratory pressure? What is this point? Who can tell? Third point.
So, beginning of the inspiration.
Or?
Zero and expiratory pressure.
Or end of expiration. Beginning of inspiration or end of?
End of expiration.
Both are same. End of expiration. This point, this particular point. So now what is ZEEP means? Zero end expiratory pressure. So at the end of expiration, the pressure within the lung is zero. That is the meaning. Clear? Zero end expiratory pressure. That is, at the end of expiration, if the pressure within the lung is zero, it is called zero end expiratory pressure. And what is PEEP? At the end of expiration, if the pressure within the lung is positive. So how the diagram will be? I'll show here. These things you will study in ventilator. It is somewhere here. Clear? If it is reaching this particular point, it is called as ZEEP. Clear? And if does not reach this point, if it does not reach this point, then it is called positive end expiratory pressure. This is called PEEP. Clear? And what is negative? NEEP, negative end expiratory pressure. Now, what is the advantages of these positive and negative? All is having advantage and disadvantage. It depends on the condition of the patient. Now, what we are going to discussing here, PEEP. PEEP, that is positive PEP devices. PEP devices allows the lung, listen carefully, the PEP devices allows the lung to have positive pressure at the end of expiration. Again, I'll repeat. PEP devices allow the lungs to have, or it does not allow the lung to go for zero. It does not allow the lung to fall the pressure to zero. It maintains the positive pressure even after the expiration, completion of expiration. Even at the end of expiration, the pressure remains in the lung positive. That is the advantage of this device. So what is the need of this? What is the advantages of, what is the need? Normally, see, if the lung this is normal alveoli and this is diseased alveoli. Here. So normally the alveoli, this is normal alveoli and this is called radial traction. Radial traction. So here in the diseased alveoli, you can see the alveoli is diseased or it cannot expand properly. Clear? So here there is a secretions and a fibrosis, and this is fibrosis and narrowing of the lung. Clear? This is narrowing. So this is diseased alveoli. This is fibrosis, secretion, mucus, and narrowing. Here it is normal in the first alveoli. So now we will, what is happening during inspiration? When you are doing inspiration, listen carefully, or I will give in another color. When you are doing during inspiratory phase, what will happen? The airway will open and alveoli will inflate. This is during inspiration. Clear? So during inspiration, the airway remains open. Listen carefully. During inspiration, because of positive pressure, you are blowing the air in. You know, the air is moving in. So what will happen? The airway will open. Airway will open. And alveoli will expand. So what happens during expiration? During expiration phase, what happens? Listen carefully. During expiration, again, the inflated alveoli will come back to its original position. Like this. It comes back to original position, but it does not go further small.
It does not become further small. Why? Because radial, because of the radial traction. Because of the radial traction, the airway will not collapse. Airway will not collapse. It will come to back to its original position, but it will not further collapse because the radial traction prevents the airway from collapse. Clear? But this airway remains open during inspiration. The airway remains open because of positive pressure, not because of radial traction. Clear? Because of positive pressure, airway will open. But during expiration, positive pressure is not present during expiration. So what is responsible, what is necessary to maintain the airway open? That is radial traction. This is normal. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
But in second case, diseased alveoli, listen carefully now. During in diseased alveoli, this is diseased alveoli, and during inspiration, listen, during inspiration, positive pressure is created. Now the alveoli, here it is narrowing. Clear? It is narrowing. Already it is narrowed. Okay. During inspiration, what will happen? The airway will open. The airway will open. During inspiration, airway will open. And alveoli will slightly, I'll make another. Alveoli will slightly expand. And alveoli is open. This is during inspiration. But what happens during expiration? During expiration, because there is no radial traction. Now there is what I have told. Normally the alveoli it has, sorry, airway it has
radial traction,
which will keep the airway open. During expiration, the airway is kept open. Now, because in diseased alveoli, this radial traction is absent, during expiration, that is during, if when the positive pressure is lost, you know, during expiration, what happens? Positive pressure is lost. But during inspiration, what happens? Positive pressure is gained. Positive pressure is gained. Clear? So now, because positive pressure is lost, what will happen? The airway will get collapsed again. Airway will collapse because radial traction is absent. Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
So what happens in this situation? The air has gone in, but air is trapped inside. During expiration, air is trapped because radial traction is absent. So air is trapped. Why the air is trapped? Answer is, this is the answer. Positive pressure is lost. Or in other words, airway will remain open when, if the airway is
having positive pressure. Are you agreeing with this statement?
Yes, sir.
So here, when during inspiration, airway will remain open. During inspiration, airway will remain open because positive pressure is created, generated. But airway remains closed, or airway remains closed during expiratory phase. So what is happening in expiration? Positive pressure is lost. So what is the concluding statement? Airway will remain open if the airway is having positive pressure. Another statement. Airway will close if the lung or airway is having negative pressure or zero pressure. Clear? So during these two situations, what will happen? The airway will get collapsed. So that is the main principle here. Positive expiratory pressure. So this equipment, it helps to keep the airway positive at the end of expiration. Even at the end of expiration, some amount of air is left in the lung or in the airway due to reverse pressure, back pressure. And due to back pressure, the airway is remain open. Airway will kept open. That is the main advantage and use of this equipment. So what is the other example? What is the other example? Even pursed lip breathing. Lip breathing. Clear? You know what is pursed lip breathing?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Pursed lip breathing.
Pursed lip breathing, it also helps to keep the airway positive pressure. Pursed lip breathing, because you are not allowing all the air to exhale immediately. Clear? So you are slowly, you are exhaling. Clear? When you are exhaling slowly, what happens? Due to back pressure, clear, the air which is remaining in the airway will keep the airway open. Clear? Suppose imagine you are exhaling air. Sorry. During expiratory phase, clear? So if the airway is clear. Suppose if you are exhaling, if the airway is large, clear. If the airway is large, air will easily move out. But if the airway is small, then what will happen? The air which will this part of the air will go out, but this part of the air will reflect. And this part of the air will reflect. Clear? Now, this will open the airway. This will keep the airway open. The reflected air will keep the airway open. At the same time, some amount of air will go out. So this is the principle behind pursed lip breathing and PEP devices. Positive expiratory pressure, prolonged exhalation with positive pressure stabilizes the smaller airway. Clear? This stabilization is lost. Clear? In diseased airway, this stabilization of the smaller airway is lost.
So prolonged exhalation with positive pressure, it stabilizes the airway and it keeps the airway open. Clear? Allowing the inhaled air to pass, and then on exhalation moves the secretion into larger airways. Clear? So this is the principle or theory. Clear? Patient exhales through flow restrictor via mask or mouthpiece and then perform huff or cough. That is a typical treatment, lasts about 15 to 20 minutes. So this is the equipment. You can check it later on. And there is one more equipment called flutter valve. Here, theory we will discuss next class. Or I will finish. Only one slide is left. So all these, after performing all these techniques, what's the signs of postural hypotension? Because if you are treating the lower lobes, the patient, there may be a slight change in the pressure. Clear? There may be a slight change in the blood pressure, and you check for the changes after treatment. And if the cuff is not productive, clear? If the cuff is not productive, that is, if you cannot able to clear the secretion immediately after treatment, sometimes the cuff may be productive later on, after some time. So don't expect that after postural drainage, immediately the cuff should be removed. Clear? For some patients, it will be cleared immediately. And for some patients, it may take time. And next, auscultate over the segments before and after postural drainage. And check whether the breath sounds are normal or not. You know, because after clearance, after secretion clearance, the breath sound should be normal. So you have to auscultate whether you have done properly or not. Observe the breathing pattern. It should be changed. Clear? And observe the symmetry of chest wall, whether it is expanding bilaterally, symmetrically or not. And when you should discontinue, when you should stop, when the x-rays are relatively normal. And it's not clear, it is relatively clear. And when the normal breath sounds are heard, clear. If patients are on regular home program, then you can stop PD. So how do we know that what you have done has worked or not? Sputum production should be there, should increase. Breath sound should be normal. X-ray should be normal. ABG, arterial blood gas analysis should be normal. Oxygenation should become improved. And patients will have subjective response. So by this, you can know that what you have done is acceptable or it is good. You have given proper treatment to the patient. Any doubt?
No, sir.
So we will discuss this treatment part separately sometime later. So this we have discussed just what you will be doing during postural drainage and after. Okay, one second. Thirty-five.